The Civil War preserved the Union. The Civil War ended legal slavery. But for the next almost 100 years, we found that segregation and Jim Crow, the Reconstruction period, failed. We found that slavery still existed by another name, not called slavery, but for all practical purposes, it was almost slavery. And so we needed another Civil War, a Civil War of the mind, a Civil War of courage, a Civil War of character. And that Civil War was not led by Abraham Lincoln, of course, it was led by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Dr. Martin Luther King used those same values from the Gettysburg Address to give his greatest speech. He was standing in front of the Lincoln Memorial, as he said, in the symbolic shadow of Lincoln. And when he gave his famous peroration, he said, "I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed, that all men are created equal." That creed that Lincoln had put at the center of what it meant to be an American 100 years before. And every great movement, every great social change in our country always harkens back to those core American values.
Over time, of course, it becomes adopted by almost everybody, not just in the United States, but elsewhere, because it is so succinct, because it puts out these principles that almost anybody can identify with: equality, nationality, and democracy.
I mean, my mother memorized the Gettysburg Address, and I memorized it. My daughter will memorize it. I mean, it's because it is brief, it's teachable, and it can be part of oral history, and you can pass it on.
More than two centuries later, a government of the people, by the people, and for the people has not perished from the earth.
I don't think anyone today, no speechwriter, no politician could come up with what, I mean, that's a unique moment, not just in our history, it's a unique moment in world history. That speech, the Gettysburg Address, is learned and recited all over the world. It is a unique moment in human history. Phrases of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth. I can't say those phrases now without choking up. The power of those few words, I mean, it resonates 150 years later. It will stand forever.